Welcome to the corridors of power.
She's the baby of the house, Westminster's youngest MP, the TikTok generation's answer to politics. This queer-identifying former care worker was catapulted to the green benches 2 years ago, age 23. One of the rare success stories of Corbyn's 2019 election catastrophe.
On behalf of all the Labour candidates...
She's nursing the flame of Labour's left. But the return to Parliament this year is Nadia Whittome's toughest challenge yet.
The best way that I would describe it is as feelings of recurring terror, absolute terror.
Earlier this summer, she was diagnosed with PTSD and told to take time off work.
I think that it's a diagnosis that is quite misunderstood. If you imagine re-experiencing the worst thing that has ever happened to you, and then straight afterwards you've got to go and give a speech or chair a meeting.
We're a generation that is brave, collaborative and outward-looking.
I've given a lot of thought as to whether to talk about the causes of my PTSD, and ultimately I decided not to because it wouldn't be helpful for my recovery. But I will go as far as saying that the traumatic events that resulted in my PTSD were extremely traumatic and serious and completely unrelated to Parliament or my work as an MP. The reason that I decided to be open about my diagnosis was I felt that if anything good could come of this horrible situation, and if it could in any way chip away at the stigma surrounding mental ill health, then that was something good that could come out of it.
What has your own experience of PTSD made you understand is wrong in the way that other people think about it?
When I took time off, the overwhelming response was very positive. You'll have seen some of the coverage that suggested that because I hadn't been in a war, that I couldn't have PTSD, or speculating that it was because of my age or because I was too inexperienced, or I'd been reading mean things about myself online. I mean, that is ridiculous to anyone who's so much as Googled PTSD. That's not how you get PTSD. And what makes me worry is the impact that that has on other people with PTSD or with other mental health conditions who have to read that, and then how their diagnosis is received by other people as a result of that.
You talk about the privilege, as you put it, of being able to take time off work and also being able to seek help privately because, as I understand it, your GP told you the waiting list on the NHS would have taken months.
Yeah, initially I was seen by the NHS, as I always have been, and then I was told that the waiting list would be months and months. It's not something that I wanted to do. Me accessing treatment allowed me to be in a place where I was well enough to return, and where I can now continue to make that recovery. And everybody who has experienced something very traumatic and as a result has PTSD should have the right to that. There shouldn't be a cost attached to it.